So I've been in Italy for 5 weeks now. I can hardly believe it. And I'm living this extraordinary life. And the other day I was looking through some paperwork, some notes from a course that I had taken not too long ago, actually just last year. And I found something that I had created for myself about an extraordinary life. And what I wrote is that in my extraordinary life, I'm a daily contribution to others, have meaningful conversations with people every day. I have vitality and energy when I wake up, and I'm filled with joy in each moment, or I possess the ability to transform each moment into joy. Emotionally, I'm happy and fulfilled by knowing my being alive is a benefit to everyone around me. So people have been reaching out to me and, commenting on the fact that I'm having this amazing life and that I'm living my dreams. I'm so lucky, and it didn't happen by chance. I'm not lucky. I created this life. I'm sure you can think of times when maybe you have felt pure joy in the realization or completion of your desires. However, expressing the joy is one thing. Being conscious of how you're doing it is another. So by definition, an extraordinary life is a life of joy, meaning, and magnificence. Living your life on your terms, whatever that means to you. So, what creates an extraordinary life? What forces or shapes the direction and determines your destiny? And how can you harness that? So, the first thing is it has to be created. What does an extraordinary life look like to you? When I created that for myself, I said that I wanted harmony in my family, really being a contribution, a real contribution to others, more fun and time for things that I love, and the financial ability to do the things that I want. And this is what I created, and that was in November. So, 8 short months later, here I am living it. When I read this, I almost couldn't believe it. I thought, is it really that simple? I just create it and then it happens. And it's not that simple. You don't just create it and it automatically falls into your lap. But the creation of it is the first thing. And the second thing is, looking at what's missing. For me, what was missing is I cared too much about what other people thought. I wasn't focused. I was really easily distracted by other things that were happening in my life, which, we often are, and especially as women. And my limiting beliefs. Those limiting beliefs are the things that'll kill every single dream. When you look at what's missing, then you can start to identify where it is that you need to be working, what it is that you need to be working on. And providence moves. Things then will start to happen where you'll notice that you're starting to get yourself out of your way. I know that I did for myself. We talk a lot about limiting beliefs in my Future by Design course and how those things stop you, how they your morals and values that oftentimes people hand off to you, they're not even yours, are the things that then start to shape you, and you live your life like those are the things that are the guiding star or the lighthouse, instead of looking inside and looking what's in your heart. So when you start to define what's missing, that's when you're going to start to notice what it is that you need to do and what it is that you need to get out of the way in order to start to move things forward for yourself. Definitely, I did that. I really don't care too much about what other people think. That's a huge transformation that's been happening for me. I shared that with you last week. And definitely the focus, because I know what I want and I actually see it in arm's reach now. Funny how that happens. The last thing is when you see what's missing, you have to start to look at what it is that needs to shift. So, what do you need to change to make life happen on your terms? What do you need to change now? And for me, again, it was the clear focus, having that clear focus. And definitely, you can't hit a target that you can't see. So until you actually create it and it's very clear and definite for you, even beyond those things that we're afraid to say, because sometimes we're afraid to say what it is that we want. There's a saying, don't wish for what you want, you might get it. But it's definitely inside of not even a want, but your desires. Your desires are that thing in the future that's calling you. It's not something that you need to get to. It's something that when you hear that coming back to you, you know that, you know, you're in the right place and this is the way it's supposed to be, that gut feeling that we sometimes call it. Having a plan, like absolutely 100%. You can't get anywhere without a plan. If I told you to come over to my place, you'd need a plan to get there. You need a map, you need some direction. Otherwise, you just get in your car and start driving, and that's fun too, but you're not gonna get to your destination. You have to make difficult decisions. I had to make a lot of difficult decisions, and I probably will have to make a lot more difficult decisions. But you know, how you make them, we talked about making decisions as well too. And again, in the course, we look at the decision-making process and what it is that we really do consider when we're making a decision. And really getting that clear for ourselves. Are you making decisions for yourself, or are you making them for other people? The fulfillment, yes, you know, having the people in your life that you care about around you be happy is important, but you're the most important person in your life. You have to enroll your environment, speaking of that, because once you do make those decisions, having people get what's possible for you in such a way that they're inspired, touched, moved by what it is that you're up to, so that they can support you. And I had to do a lot of enrolling to come down here, and I probably will have to do a lot more enrolling. I had to enroll my family, I had to enroll my clients, I had to enroll my financial institution and my personal banker, the people that are looking out for me. And but you know what I've really noticed is people don't know what I want, and it's difficult sometimes to communicate that to people. But you know what you want, and that has to be your guiding star. And the last thing that needs to shift, and I said this before, is your limiting beliefs. That inner villain inside that keeps telling you what you can and what you can't, and what's right and what's wrong and what's good and what's bad, those beliefs limit you. They stop you from achieving what's possible. I really feel like I'm living this extraordinary life, out of the ordinary. And I really do wake up every morning. I was sharing this with somebody the other day. I really do wake up every morning almost laughing, smiling, happy. This is not because of, you know, where I am, but that I've actually done it. Like, I've actually created and fulfilled on this life that I wanted. And I see how I can live this way for the rest of my life. And I see how. And where I don't see how, I'm working on that part too. So nobody is normal. You can be normal, but we all have the ability for what is extraordinary. And maybe that means just starting by defining what is ordinary and figuring out for yourself if that's good enough for you. And if it's not, giddy up. Have a great day, everybody. Toodles from Sicily.